Hey there everyone, SpooferJahk here again, and in this video, I will show you how to downgrade the Steam version to the 1.0 release and make some improvements to it, step by step. If you have seen the previous comparison, then you'll know why the Steam version sucks so bad. Not only does it lack the second edition fixes, which were out like a decade ago, but also is missing a lot of the soundtrack and ability to mod the game and play the beloved SAMP modification. Also, I missed another fact. If you complete Vigilante level 12, it tells you that your maximum armor is increased. Actually, this feature is bugged on Steam and it doesn't give you anything there despite telling you about the bonus. So without further ado, let's get straight to the tutorial. First of all, I would strongly advise you to reinstall the game through Steam, because having a clean version increases your chances in a successful downgrade. After you did that, go into the Steam Apps Common folder and rename or move the San Andreas folder. In my case, I decided to rename it. In the future, this will prevent Steam from updating modified files if there is an update for this game. When you are done, go to this forum thread and download the Downgrader by using any of these links. You can either select the full version with pre-downloaded patches, or a version that downloads the patches separately. I chose the first one. The link to this forum thread and all the future links can be found in the description below for your reference. Launch the tool you just got and agree to the terms. Then agree to download the missing files. It will take up about 500 megabytes of space. Just find the folder with your Steam version and click on the San Andreas executable so you could downgrade it. But wait, we all know that the vanilla 1.0 version isn't any better than the poor Steam version. That's why we have this box with essential modifications in this tool. You definitely want to check these mods out. I would strongly recommend you to install the silent patch. It will fix a lot of bugs, such as adding an ability to use widescreen resolutions like 1080p, as well as fixing the pesky mouse bug and much, much more. Trust me, you won't regret this. By the way, you can always click on these names to read about the mods more in depth. You can install a mod loader if you like modding your game, but sadly, I am not experienced with it, so you will have to read up on this yourself. Speaking of remastered GUI, this pack has been put together to bring the updated textures from newer versions of San Andreas back to the PC version, which gives an overall quality boost to the GUI. Once again, you will not want to ignore this modification. Project 2DFX is a set of plugins for San Andreas, which increases object draw distances, adds LOD corona effects, fixes flickering and holes in the map, a limit adjuster, and a total increased object limit, which cannot be achieved with any other limit adjuster. Yet again, something you might want to use. Regarding the 13AG widescreen fix, the widescreen resolution in the vanilla game kinda looks weird. That's why I'm recommending you to install this mod as well. You can see a quick comparison below. We know that the Steam version got native Xbox 360 controller support, which was missing in the day one release. So we know it kinda sucked there. If you want to play with a gamepad like a true G, I would strongly advise you to install the G input mod. Not only does it add improvements to different controllers, but also adds rumble support. Try it for yourself. What is more important is that you can install the San Andreas multiplayer mod and it won't crash with these fixes and patches. I tested it to make sure of that. Or you can install Multi-Theft Auto. It is up to you. By the time you see this video, there might be more mods added here. Just click on the name to see what they do. I also assume you would like to install the Clio mod. That's why the link can be found in the description below. When you decided what you want to see in your fresh version, tick whatever mod you want and click on Downgrade. If you want to read more about it in depth, it would be best to pause the video now. I would recommend you to click here, because it will create a registry entry to this specific version so the mods could find this folder without having you to select it. After a short period of time, you will have converted the Steam release into the first release with music restored. Awesome-tacular! By the way, I would strongly recommend you to click on the Tools button and then on Delete Settings File. This option will remove the gta_sa.set file in your save game folder, which will prevent a game crash upon starting it up. Also, you can select French, Italian, or German languages here. You won't be able to choose them in game, unfortunately. If you want to use your Steam saves, then you have to convert them by using this special website. Just drag and drop your save game there. Then click on Modifications and choose Unmodified, V1, and V1. Then choose a slot and you are ready to replace the new save and continue your game experience. Sometimes there is a pesky bug on Windows 10 where it doesn't allow you to minimize or alt-tab the game. If you want to fix that, just look at this video and follow those simple steps. I hope this video was helpful for you and everything went right when downgrading your Steam copy of San Andreas. That's pretty much it. I only showed the basics to make this game stable and moddable, and did not show some of the more intricate and elaborate mods you can add to make this game even more special. Those you can check out yourself, but for now you have a nice and playable version of the 1.0 release to play and mod to your heart's content. This has been SpooferJahk for another Vadim M video. Thanks for watching.